Good evening, everyone. Well, 3.8 live stream na now, so I'm doing a showcase for Wanderer. Wait, let me just, there we go. I'm doing a showcase for Wanderer. Where is she? Hey, let me just sort. Doing a Yula. And of course, Kokomo. I'm doing a showcase for all three. Possibly in with 4 star. Thank you, Wanderer. I'm gonna showcase Wanderer with the best of my ability with my 4 stars at the very least. Though keep in mind some of them are C6 like Toma. Bennett is C5. And Yunjin is C6, so Wanderer but my Wanderer is C0. This is for everyone who is very lucky with their 4 star pool or very unlucky. Because I just love this dude. So what you can expect for Wanderer is he is very squishy. Like seriously, this is his stats at bare minimum. His ascension stat is crit rate, so you won't be having a trouble time with farming for crit rate on his artifacts. And as you can see, he has a pretty good crit ratio on my end. Let me just use some energy. I would honestly consider him a hyper carry because looking at looking at his kit. This just transforms. This just transforms him in and give him a serious boost compared to his normal attacks. And this is just nuts on his own. His passive gives him some pretty good passive on Overworld and even Abyss. Though I don't recommend him in floor 11 or even floor 12. Maybe 9 or 10. If you have Hydro, you can increase his skill stamina by 20. This is the initial points is 100. Pyro, which is my favorite, increases attack since his crit rate ascension is nearly 20%, so I don't use Cryo on him. But Electro, he honestly catches his own particles, so I don't recommend an Electro with him. But this, it's a nice buff, but I don't even know if it's a normal attack or skill attack, because unlike him, Ningguang, this is considered a charge attack. Her jades. Her star jades, these are considered normal attacks, which can be buffed by Yun Jin. Let me give a demonstration for Ningguang. So I wanna figure out if this is not correct. If Yun Jin can buff Ningguang. Let me just get her previous artifact. This was her own artifact before I got Kaching. Let me just do a demonstration first, so I can give you an idea. Oh wait. What does his it causes 4000 geo damage? I forgot Toma CC's can boost normal attack, charge attacks, and everything. How about I test it with Yun Jin? No, it died too quickly. So her star jade behind her, this one, when you do a charge attack, that counts as normal attack.
Boken da boken. Oops.
It's not even creating. I need a bigger. I need a thicker target. Thousand, wow, does boost him, boost her, even with Bennett Bow. Hindi. Wala, nagla-live stream ako, ma. This is not going great, but you get the idea. It does boost her attacks a bit, her Jade, Star, this Star Jade, it boosts her with normal attack though. How about I do it with Wanderer? Because I don't know if his A4 Ascension passive affects is affected by Yunjin's Burst.
に何をしてほしいんだい? 冒険だ冒険。
I don't think it does it, unfortunately. That's just the Bennett buff. It just buffs his normal attack. But as you can see, he needs support to be a hyper kill. Oh wait, no, it does buff him. It got to this normal attack. How about we go now? Wow, it does 4,000 attack per hit. Almost the same as Ningguang. And Ningguang just... How many Winpei Guild does he use? Oh, 4. Yeah, but as you can see, I usually run him with Pyro Residence. At bare minimum. If you have Zhongli though. I think it's the same. It's the same or more damage than usual. Because I use the Enduring Rock for Wanderer, because he gets interrupted really easily. And Zhongli... Oh, whoops. Zhongli is just here for the Rush Red. Just for the shield, to be perfectly honest. And the Enduring Rock. Because I love this buff. The Avenger showcase is fighting Raiden Shogun because she's a very good punching bag that hits back. Very good in simple As you can see, I'm dealing almost 30k damage on him. And without the stun, he deals half of that. Now I will do it without Zhongli, because not everyone has Zhongli, especially for newcomers.
Yeah.
I will be putting Tommy Ting in his Kitty Cross Spear. The Blaze Oblige. I don't think I can. I don't think. What does it called? Tenacity. Oh yes, he does it proc it with burst. Oh wait, if I base it on the... Whoops. I'm using Toma against Riding Shoulder. Ooh, that was close. Hono no tate. Oh, he's dealing almost 25k. That's not bad. I love this guy so much. Normal attack. I love normal attack characters. But yeah, that's just Wanderer. He needs a perfectly functioning team like Toma. I recommend Zhongli for in exchange if you don't have him. Especially, my Toma is C6. This boss is normal. This boss Wanderer's attacked by a lot. With Yunjin and Bennett. And my Yunjin is C6. So Wanderer is now a machine gun. Though I don't have the Desert Pavilion artifact, two piece is generally fine for him. I don't usually farm another artifact since he honestly carry on his own. So with Toma, he has energy issues. Especially if he is C0. I'd recommend him, if you have Toma at C4, use him with Wanderer. As for Farzan though, I honestly don't recommend her using with Wanderer because her energy issues. I don't like using her with even at C2. It's barely making a difference. Though with C6 Farazan, that's maybe a bit different, but I don't have her yet. I don't have her at C6 just yet. How about we try him in Abyss? Let's see how we can compare. This is multi-target though. I don't honestly use him in Abyss like this, especially floor 12. Though for the sake of this live stream, I wanna test him if he is good enough for even chamber 1. It does give me a boon for normal charge attack, so that's a plus. The damage is just... Yes, it's very slow. Wow. I don't like this. やりよ。属性を見よらせん。 I can even do it in 3, in 3 minutes or less. Though I use charge attack for that, but I'm not really a big fan for charge attack, so he is honestly better with single target. And later chamber has bosses in them. I mean, look. You need to get the gymnastics over this on the first chamber before getting to the single target bosses. And I don't think I can handle the concentrate. I don't think Mother can handle consecrated beast too, because how even with Catalyst, I don't think he can even fight those. These are what, level 100. And my wonder is just level 80 still. And I ain't farming for level 90 for him. So I recommend Wanderer Havers and Wanters. I mean, for Wanderer Wanters, I recommend him in Overworld because of this. This is just fun. Especially if you have Sayu. You can move fast. Especially if you're in the desert, let me just give you a demonstration.
Yeah.
This is just for your enjoyment. And you can traverse the desert really fast if you have animal resonance. This is just stupid fun, and I love it. Rolling around at the speed of sound. Next, I want to showcase a new special character of mine. You already know I love using her in Overworld. So let us showcase Eula at the very minimum. Well, mostly minimum. From all of the experimented team I did for Eula, I think this is the most realistic. Especially if you have C6 Rosaria.
いい天気だ。ただどうも嫌な予感がする。私の考えすぎだといいけど。
Though one thing to note, Eula is honestly very energy hungry because her burst cost is 80. You need a cryo battery like Rosaria. If you don't have Cookie or Rosaria on your team, I do recommend the Yona because of her healing and her shield. Because the defense bonus per stack is, I don't like that. Because Eula, as far as I know, without shield or healing, is very squishy without defense. Let me show you.
Yeah,
I am not a big fan of the. Defense bonus on her. But as you can see, Yula with both gravestone, she's very nuts. The key with hyper carries like Yula and Wanderers, they need the best team, though. I doubt Yunji or even Rosario will be in their banner. Not even Toma, I think, because they had their banners. They had their banners a few months ago. Unless they did another one. Let me just kill Shinobu. As you can see, Yula can barely get her energy. You honestly need a cryo battery for her. Keeping Yula alive is the main priority here. With the best weapon imaginable, especially gravestone. But how about I show you with a free to play weapon? I doubt you can win the lose the 50-50 with this. Let's start with Star Silver. Long time zero kill. Even at R1, it's pretty good. As you can see, Yula needs a lot of setup. Like Wanderer, I don't recommend her in Floor 12 at all. She can do fine, to be perfectly honest, but with that Wandering Showcase, I doubt she can perform well in the current Abyss. A lot of the enemies are multi-target. So as you can see, even with the free-to-play weapon, she can do well. The one thing I can advise though, do not use C0 Mika. Even with Pavonius Plus, he can barely battery Yula. Diona is better than him. And I love Mika, goddammit. I like his character, his design. He looks like a freaking chocobo. Everybody say he's a chocobo boy. They compare him as Pazero Zod with C6, but a lot of people telling everybody, especially if you use Yula, it doesn't snapshot if you switch early. Like if you end Yula's burst prematurely to get to reset your rotation for your team. Once the buff for you for Mika's burst and skill run out, it doesn't snapshot. Or doesn't even take the buff. It only calculates Yula's current buff. I honestly recommend Yunjinku, Shinobu, and Rosaria. I did it, great. I forgot Yula doesn't have a... Yula doesn't have a very good crit rate on her other artifacts. Also, one of Yula's weaknesses I showed you. She she doesn't work well with very mobile bosses, especially single target bosses. Let me show you with Kapachir, the Thunder manifestation. Wanderer, okay, he can be fine with bosses like this, but with Thunder Manifestation, I don't recommend it. She can work fine, but in the Abyss, Thunder Manifestation will waste a lot of time. I'd recommend Yula for just, or honestly, Overworld, to be honest. Her team is very limited. At least my team is very limited. Even reading her cons, I don't think I want her cons either. Maybe C1. But I'm waiting for Fontaine. Tidal Illusion C1, maybe I can get it, but 4.0 is coming to a close. Coming close soon. So I'm saving for the Fontaine characters. Thank you. But last but certainly not the least, I'll show you one of my very first 5-star Hydro character, Kokomi. I often use her a lot in Abyss. She's that good. I honestly want her donut, but I already have prototype Amber R3, and it worked wonder. Though I crowned her burst because I honestly like, I just like normal attack Kokomi. Let me show you one of her best teams of Kokomon. Keep in mind, my Sucrose is C6. Fischl is C4. And Xiangling is C6. Let me just get Kazuha's artifacts. Let me just show her her best team. Kokomi, I don't usually experiment on her. Well, until today. Because I like Kokomi's hydro application in her jellyfish. I dabble in normal attacks, but I mean, she can do damage, but you. Hey. I haven't played Tsukokomon for a long while, so I'm a little scared of the rotation. Now, how about I show you a meme team? Keep in mind, Xingqiu is also C6 with an R5 sacrificial sword. You won't believe me. I'm AR60. I have been playing for a long while. No, no. It's one. I started in 1.5. Eula's first rerun, first banner, and Zombie's rerun. Though keep in mind, I'm free to play, but I don't honestly. That doesn't hold any candle. I'm invested a lot of characters. Free to play is very misleading. I grind every day. So my artifacts RNG is pretty good. My artifacts roll are pretty good. Hello. A fellow Filipino, I see. Good to know, good to know. I can speak Tagalog, but I'm already used to speaking English. I know, right? I think Sincho did all of the damage. But as you can see, she's a pretty good healer. I know. I freaking know. Let me try something else. Candace. Bennett. No, not Bennett. I think Toma would be better to showcase. Just to showcase Kokomi's personal damage. I'll use prototype Amber for now because I don't think none of these characters will benefit with the with training tails. That way, you can showcase Kokomi's personal damage. I would love to use C6 Yunjin, but she already taken the spotlight already. C6 Yuji is so fun. I use him with Wanderer and Eula. Though I don't recommend them in Abyss, especially at C0. I'm just honestly doing it for fun. Oh nice, that's a very good team. I recommend Ayato for that. Ayato, Wanderer. Yes. The machine gun team. How about I do that with Kokomi? I know, that's That's a pretty fun event. You can test all of the characters. I can finally play Hu Tao. I miss Hu Tao because I had to get Yaban. Though, as you can see, she's pretty slow for a single target. Oh, that's so bad. I hope we can get her. Don't let me out. Let me just try out my new team. Oh, that's pretty ironic. I'm so sorry. Don't let me just get. Let's try Machine Gun Kokomi. Because I do have C6 Gene. On the bright side, I have a 4 element field for Yunjin's A4 Ascension. C2. Only C2, unfortunately. Though I doubt I can get energy from. Yes. Unless if you try to get C4 or Hazel or even Wanderer, but I don't like that. You need to be inside Jin's burst circle. Oh, by the way, I have all of them in Fabonius. So I doubt I'll have energy problem. Let me just battery my Kokomi. Yes. Let me just set it up. Take it. That's barely any damage. Six to 7K per hit. Let's try that again. Oh, that's just religious. Prototype Amber. Just for their energy problem. I have Ocean Ryu Dramon call for me. Yeah. But it does stack. I mean the damage will stack with the healing. I honestly don't recommend on driver Kokomi, just don't use her in normal attack or single target. Just use her for teaser team, because the range on this jellyfish is pretty good. Oh yeah, she's pretty good. Let me show you. I do have Nilo. Amadare ishi o mugatsu. I'll use Kabe for as a driver. No, not Kabe. I think I'll do Kabe. You got that. Yeah, my team name for Bloom, Hyperloop Bloom and Virgin is gardening. Yeah. Oops, I forgot to switch. Keep in mind, this is a very expensive team. My Xingqiu is C6. My Nilo is just C0. So is my Kokomi. Though I honestly keep her in Trailing Tails. And Kabe, he's just here for to be a driver. I whoops! They switched too early. Kabi does have healing, so it's a bit redundant. Maybe I should change to Kole. Just to showcase her healing abilities. My Kole is C4 though. Sorry Goro, I did your R5 sacrificial. Just for the Dendro application. And calling is back to normal. This analysis just became a Nilo showcase, but it does keep Kole alive. You get the picture. Pretty good team. Although I don't think I want her constellation. C1 just and it just boosts her last attack, this one. That one, that's just boost their third attack. And this just boosts her healing bonuses. Which means it's boosts her this one. Her A1 passive. C3 is for her burst. I already have Yunjin for that. And prototype Amber. Just for his skills. I can already get her constellation with her team. She's pretty good at C0, to be honest. What am I doing? Oh wait, we need to adjust Kazuha's artifacts. I wanna showcase Kokomi in Kokomi's best team in floor 12 at the very least. What is the second tip? Okay, Nahida, you're in the second half. I just want to show you how nuts her healing is. And her hydro application. If I remember correctly, every jellyfish tick deals hydro damage. So that's like infinite. That's like infinite hydro and freezing. Also, Ayaka is my first limited standard batter. Oh wow. I honestly hate this chamber so much. Because it doesn't spawn the enemies per group. They spawn them one by one. Also, Kazuma is still in the matter, so I recommend getting him now. His banner is coming. It's ending soon, so I recommend getting him now if you have. Unless you already have him, so. As you can see, Kokomi just freezes shit. Oh, what constellation are you? I hate this chamber so much. Chamber floor 12, chamber 1. As you can see, I mean, it's manageable. I'm just doing this for the Primo Gem. I hate this backup dancer so much. I do not recommend it, especially if you're casual playing this. Or even attempting Pyro the Beast 12. But yeah, Kokomi is good. Yeah, it's not worth it. A lot of players is complaining this iteration of Spiral Abyss. As you can see, I am not planning to perfectly cleared the whole Spider-Beast floor 12. Because what's the point? I can get the 50 Primer Gems the next day. I'll just farm the domains for now. I'm looking for a pretty good pieces for Emblem of Severed Fates. I've been farming this artifact for 2 months now. Even though I have a perfectly good Raiden Shogun. How come? You hate it for the grind. I honestly can't blame you. Every server rate is pretty good. Though I have been farming this domain for nearly 2 fucking years. Non-stop. This annoying little fuckers. Though the good thing about farming this, I can use the strong box.
Yuko. Iza.
excuse me. Though I'm kinda jealous of Hoyo's new game, Star Rail. They added they added the item that can let you choose substats. I really want it in Genshin Impact, but they put it in Star Rail. Nothing against it, just a little salty. Just a little salty. Hoyoverse put that in Star Rail instead of Genshin. I know. It's kinda unfair. No, it's real. It's literally unfair. Ah yes, a Yunjin artifact. So other than Fontaine, I honestly want them to improve the quality of life for Genshin. A new region is great, but I just want the quality of life in Skyrim put in Genshin.
Yeah, don't laugh.
Don't tap at other people's misery. I know, I was so excited for that. She said this is not my thing, but I can honestly expect a full-blown furry in Fontaine. I do hope they added more of them. I'll take a full-blown adult meal. I'm sorry, I got excited over there. I pressed the wrong button. And I'm perfectly fine with that. They did it. Hoyoverse did it in Genshin Zone Zero. I am ready for full-blown furries in Fontaine. Oh. Yeah, die, just die, die, die! Die for my amusement. Yeah, sure. Healing bonus. Though honestly, does Eplin work with Kokomi? I haven't tried that. I doubt it though. One and a started point to the grind. Oh, Elemental Master, I'm keeping that. I'm keeping that.
much.
Okay, I think that's it up for today. Let's see who we can raid today. Let's raid my good friend. Was there he is doing Mega Man Battle Network 5. And thank you for Lewinsky Jojo. Thank you for hanging out with me. But yeah, thank you everyone for watching. I hope you have a good evening, a good morning, a good afternoon, and a good night. I'll see you Tuesday. I'll be doing the whole face trial. I'm just streaming this Sunday so I can get a rest. See you in the next stream. Take care, everyone. And thank you, Lewinsky Jojo, for following. I appreciate it.